Okay, welcome to Darkwood. Excuse me, I gotta go. Can I adjust this? Hello? Quite good enough. Wait up a little. There we go. Okay, let's see here. It's been so long. Okay, I have searched this place, I'm pretty sure. It's been so long. Not sure if I've been in there, though. Anything in here wanna come out and kill me? There's something out there in the water. What the fuck? Oh! Is there a savage somewhere in here too, or is that the sound they actually make? Why did I bring this oxygen tank with me? Oh, it's that. That's what's making that noise. Hello. Shit. It's been so long. I don't know where any of the places I've searched. Nah, I don't need that. This. Don't like that. If I run into that chomper again, I'm not gonna have a good time. Why is there fire here? Look at that. Not sure, that might be the house that the chomper was in right there. like it. I really don't like it. Oh, fuck me. Those tree tentacle things sound so fucking crunchy. The word thieves has been scribbled across the door. Am I close to the talking tree yet? Alright, I don't want to go the other way, so this might be my only way forward. Get my lantern. Alright. Oh, that's... No, we need explosives. Okay. Scrap metal. Okay. Not that. Yeah. Y'all see this, right? This fucking thing. Where else can I go? Not much. Everywhere else has pretty much been explored. It's weird how there's no mention about the radio tower or the locked door there. I don't get it. What am I doing? I don't know what to do about these areas here with the red glowy ball of death. Oh dear! Around here too. I heard one grunting. Ugh. Yo. That note mentioned a while back that savages kept going towards that radio tower because the tunnel was there. I'm probably gonna return to like a whole horde of them. Oh, wait. Oh, I thought there were logs right there. Oh wait, there are. Search that. Search that. Oh, we found something. It's anything in here? Oh, sweet. I just no. Oh fuck, I gotta hurry up and get back. Okay, what can I get rid of? I need this. Give me that gas tank. Damn, I'm so tired. Ooh, I hear those steppy steps. What the fuck? God, the red glowy ball of death is really getting to me. It's really trying. Is it over? Please tell me it's over. There's another chomper over there. Let's see if the hunting rifle does any good. Oh, that's such a tiny reticle. Come on. Okay, I got quite a few things to repair. Gentlemen, be with you in a second. Yeah, this seems about right. I gotta replace those bear traps too. And I gotta take this hat off. Whew. Damn it! This goddamn controller. Thank you. Here we go. Ow. Holy shit. I just did that for nothing. Oh, sounds like Nana's up. What does that say there? Okay, Brent Cottage. Take the rope. Okay, so I found out what was in that room. Is this where I found that chomper? I hope not. Huh? Oh! Hi! Oh! Wait. Bloody hell. You're alive! The old man extends his hand, blindly trying to reach me. Oh man, you've seen better days, bro. You're not from around here, oh? Eh? Can it be? Hmm? All them lads are dead. It's only me. And he finally finds my arm and grabs it. For a moment, he clutches my hand in silence. Then I hear him mumbling under his breath. I don't have anything, mate. Only this. This chair. Bloody hell. His gaze stops somewhere under the leaky, burned ceiling. What? The old man suddenly jumps up. What are you saying? I feel his fingernails digging into my hand. Ain't no fucking tree, that. It looks like a tree. Just those faces. I know them buggers. Every single one of them. So close. And so fake. They're not real. They're not real. From time to time, I thank God I went blind. From time to time, I thank God I went blind. I don't have to look at them. The old man let go of my hand. So leaning against the broken back of the chair, he sighs with relief. It disgusts me. It fucking disgusts me. This buggery. This fucking scum. All the time I have to...
All the time I have to listen to pathetic blabber, complaining, all the time, as if it were supposed to believe it's human. That's Mizaka. Yeah, right. He suddenly reaches towards me with both hands. Almost falling from the chair, he grabs onto my sleeve. I feel his weight on me. You lad, you've got your hands and legs. Strong arms, I beg you. Get rid of that filth from my village. I can't hear another day of that abomination, wailing and sobbing. I want to die in peace. Fucking hell. I want to die in peace. Listen to me. I thought about it for a long time. I had a long time to think. For fuck's sake. His eyes open wide. His eyes widen. His pupils are milky white. I can feel him climbing my coat. I need to find the basement in Jarek's basement. You don't find the basement. Jarek's basement. I remember it's right near the tree. Tree is too large, so if you can't reach it from the top, you have to reach it from the bottom. Find the basement. In there, you'll find the tree's roots. The bloody thing must have roots. That's where they are. Destroy them. Pour them out. Drag them. Twist them. Twist the fuck out of them. You'll find a way. Eh? I know you will. The old man slides down my coat, straight into his destroyed wheelchair. For a moment, he searches for his stone. Searches for his stone, which he has to prop himself up against the muddy floor of the barn. Thank you. Thank you. The old man grabs a photograph, feels it, and takes out a small glass object from his pocket, puts it to his eyes. The road home, but a load of bullocks. The road to madness is what it is. Years ago, when my eyes were good, people used to pass through here. They would have their hut. They would have their huts and go. There were that damn tree groves. They would often leave a night. At night, so that no one could see them. They went to the deep dark woods, and never came back. Some of them would say that they're going home, but most of them were silent. I don't know, the land has changed. The trees have cut us off from the rest of the world, but home for me has always been here. And that monstrous, moaning abomination grew out of the ground. It blocked the passage. And that's that. No one has managed to pass through since then. Maybe people found some other place. Maybe. Maybe they died at the swamps, just like us. What are you going on about again? The old man leans forward, scowling. The wheelchair? The war took me legs. Then those wankers burned up my house and me pigs. But it was years after the war. They said it was to fight the disease. So they said, my Zaga. The disease took her for me. all I have is this wheelchair and this land. No one lives around here anymore. Everyone is dead. Only sometimes. Man lowers his voice. Sometimes I hear footsteps. They wake me up at night. The sound of bare feet against the floor. And bells, sort of. They come out of nowhere. They move towards the trees, but then come back. They pass me, fall silent. They're like a nightmare. A bloody nightmare. If you come across some wheels, two little wheels, so that I could fix me chair, maybe you would benefit from it as well. So that he needs wheels. Damn, my coffee's gone cold. It used to be different here. First the woods changed, the trees started sprouting out everywhere. We were cut off. Then the water flooded our fields. People went crazy out of hunger. They fought over food. Joke it. Okay. Hey, a fish. Okay, so we gotta do our man a solid and get rid of that tree. Meet that fish. Oh, wait, it's a healing item, I forgot. Give. Don't walk into it. Just give me. See how horrifying this actually is. Oh my god. The tree is dark, gigantic. Its bark stays in constant motion. It wells up and collapses into itself, as if breathing. I see human silhouettes growing out of the tree trunk. They're also moving, as if gesturing in slow motion. Dozens of mouths repeat their lines simultaneously, creating a uniform, noisy murmur. Between the laughs, I catch a man's gaze fixed on me. His body is similarly to the other beings. Seems to form an integral part of the tree. Sorry, I'm so far away from my TV that it's hard to read this tiny font. I see a lamb in there too. Oh, that is so unsettling. His limbs are gnarled and his face grotesquely deformed. He's the only one who acknowledges my presence. His hand slowly raises, pointing to something on the horizon. Above the roofs in the destroyed village, the man's lips are moving, but only the ghastly murmur of the other's voices drowns out his words. Kick the tree. Hoping that the voices will go silent. Try to climb the tree. look at the lips of the person talking to me. Even though the figure speaks sluggishly, it is too high for me to read his lips properly. I think one of the words is radio. I don't want to kick it, so try to climb it. The bark is slimy, soft. Its creases move away from my shoes, hands, and hands. I feel the arms that protrude from their root. I'm not sure if they want to drag me down or pull me closer. I barely break free from the grasp. Climbing is out of the question. Okay, I'm gonna kick it. I kicked the tree with all my strength, breaking a branch, sticking out from between the roots. It hurts! I hear a silent voice coming from beneath my feet. It's the face of a man who has grown into a root. He's completely covered in bark. His lips barely stick above the mud, and his raised arms resemble branches. One of them is broken at the elbow. The stump bleeds, a white, gooey substance. Instead of seeping down, it slowly flows upward, forming a new arm. I'm barely able to make any conversations and squabbles from the horrible noise the tree brought. "You took everything from us," the shouts come from an old man. Only the tip of his head and one of his arms stuck out from between the slightly crowded bodies. "You stole it, thieves. May the dogs piss on your faces." Right next to him was a woman's head, wobbling from side to side, repeats, We were hungry. Another figure, hiding its face under an enormous root, lets out a chilling shriek. "Quiet, fucking quiet. Leave us in peace. Shut up." He is interrupted by a man next to him, his intestines hanging from his stomach. It was our common good. It was meant for all of us. You stole it." High above the top of the crown, two silhouettes hanging side by side from their hands and legs, grown to the tree trunk, are trying to bite each other's faces off. "I've seen enough of this. So we just gotta take it down from the root, right?" "No, I don't need that. There's something waiting down here and I lose all my shit, I'm gonna be very mad. Oh god. Ah! A bright ominous glow of death. Hole in the wall of the basement. It must have been made when by the growing roots. "Let me get my shotgun, please. I don't trust this. Who's there? Hello? What do you want?
Oh, don't mind me. I'm just looking to leave. What does the journal entry say here? Okay, let me get my lantern. Okay, we need the oxygen tank. Alright, time to head back. I don't see anything through there. Get the hell out of here. We did make some progress, though. Come here now. Come. What's up? Basement is flooded, eh? Am I right? Dog's bullocks. Everything's fucking flooded. Turns around as if looking for something. Eh? What? Ah, yes, yes. Elephants. Fucking plonkers. Ever seen elephants, matey? Yeah. We have the elephants here. Have these elephants here. You see? They live here, in the eastern part of the swamp. Their hut is in the thicket in the flooded forest. Since the woods trapped us here, they keep to themselves. They don't fancy us, bloody elephants. They have these oxygen tanks. Lots of them tanks. If the basement is flooded, you can use an oxygen tank, eh? That's exactly what I was thinking. Yeah. No. Okay, I can probably sell these pills I got right here. There's the oxygen tank for when I need it. Yeah, here we go. I don't know why, I'm thinking of like the Great Deku Tree from Zelda for some reason.
to think for a second. You know what? I have an idea. This door here. This probably ain't gonna work, but I'm gonna give it a try. God damn it. Well, it was worth a shot. Damn it. Why am I so sleepy? Fuck you, Jerry.
Ready? Shit. Where's that? Well, that's another thing I'm gonna have to fix. Oh, hi! No, I have bandages in that spot. Hang on. Da, da, da. Hopefully that didn't just fuck up the mic there. There, I was trying to figure out that quick attack that I did before. And then it just started pounding me. Oh well. Probably don't need to fill that, it's probably fine. Hi! I still have nothing to show them, I can't talk to them or do anything. Next time, I'm gonna go down there and get rid of that tree, cause that is... Oh, fuck. I'm probably still this. Yeah. I'm probably gonna need it later though. What about... Damn, there's so much shit in here. Oh, these. I don't use them anymore. I don't have anything to use those for anymore. Just taking up space. Still have the one left in the other container though. Yeah, that's good. Hey, do you guys like fish? I got a fish. Okay. They seem satisfied. Alright, so thank you so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe if you want to. And I'll see you next time.